a bit less aggressive. He was there, like, sitting down. He heard the news, because in the moment when they heard the news, and he was jumping from the chair, trying to go close to Giovanni, the one close to Christ. He was trying to ask him something, what he was trying to ask, if he knew something more, because he knew that Giovanni was the best friend of Christ. So maybe he knew more about the news that Christ just gave. And why St. Peter has got that strange position of the arm and the hand is a bit weird? Because it was the moment he was jumping from the chair, he still had to relax. That's why it's a bit weird, the position. So if you read Da Vinci Code and Brown and you saw the movie and there are three hands, four hands, mystery, we don't understand. No, there are two hands for every hour. So that hand with the knife in a weird position is the hand of St. Peter. Why does he have a knife? Because his profession was to fish. Well, it was normal for a person who's fishing to have a knife with him. And Giovanni, that is the one close to Christ, is very relaxed. Why is not in panic as the other apostles? Because he was maybe not human as the others, because he was so close to Christ that he was already in another level, you know, so he wasn't that in panic as the more human and impulsive and the more passionate apostles. And if you read them around the Vinci Code, so the movie, she is a female, she's the Magdalene. No, he's a male, he's Giovanni. It's just that he's 16 years old, he's a teenager. That's why Da Vinci chose very sweet features, and that's why he's so sweet. But he's a male, and he's the apostle Giovanni. Who's in the middle between St. Peter and Giovanni? The one very, like, looking very bad to Giovanni, to St. Peter's, like, very bad expression of the face, and with the arm on the table. Who's that? Judas. Why we can recognize him? Because Da Vinci gave to him this particular expression of the face, but overall, on the right hand, in his pocket, with the money he received, because he betrayed Christ. Usually, the representation of the Last Supper before Da Vinci, everyone has got the heroes. And the only one without was Judas. So that was the way for us to understand who was the bad. In this case, Da Vinci chose to give us a real moment, so like not using any symbolism, so he chose to not use symbols. He had to give us other features to recognize who's the bad here. So the money, the expression of the face, and also with the right hand. Now, the restoration is the best, but we can see something. With the right hand, he's putting upside down some salt for rum on the table. What does it mean to put for rum some salt on the table? Bad luck. At least in Italy, still like that. Probably, yes, it's something popular, this tradition. Then you have to do this. So anyway. Leonardo da Vinci was trying to give every symbol possible, but very comprehensible, very understandable to anyone without, for everyone. It's very easy to understand for us who's the best. And then with Christ isolated, the making like this shape of a triangle, as you can see also there are groups of apostles, like green, green, and Christ isolated, to make it three and three. What is three? Three is the Trinity of God, so Father, Son, Holy Spirit, so underlying this. Christ is there looking down because he doesn't want to influence anyone. He said something very hard, very bad. I mean, he was there having a dinner with his friends, his apostles, and he said, someone here is going to betray me. So he's not looking anyone in the eyes because he wanted that everyone can have their own reaction without influencing anyone. His mouth is still open because he just finished to say that sentence. That's why it's the moment. And the hand that every artist tried to copy since they saw the Last Supper. One is looking down, the one close to Judah, and one is looking up, the one close to the bread. What is bread? We eat bread, meaning eating the body of Christ. And also could be a symbol that is telling us the double nature of Christ, one more human and one more divine. Do you see here there is a sort of door? The painting is a bit broken because there is this hole in the wall. Here the Dominicans were eating, right? So you had the tables, assassination. So Da Vinci was also telling us what was going to happen soon and lucky. The other one around us, we have got St. Thomas doing this with a hand with a finger, indicating God or repeating to Christ, "One of us will betray you." Then Giacomo di Medici, shocked, open up, said that, because he can't believe what he heard. Look at the right hand, how beautiful, how detailed, and how that right hand can enlarge on the space to enjoy the sort of the width between the table and the window. And then Filippo that he was seriously worried to be the one who did something bad for Franco, because he was very young, he was very naive, and he thought, oh my god, maybe it was me, I don't know. So he's there, like doing this, trying to ask Christ, please Christ, tell me it wasn't me, tell me that it hurt you, tell me it's not my fault, tell me it's not me that I didn't do something for Franco. So he was seriously worried to be the one, obviously he wasn't. The third book is Matteo. Very elegant, very nice hair, very nice movement of the hands, very nice dress, because it was the richest here. His profession was to ask for taxes, so it was a good job. And then the last two artisans, that are the oldest, Taddeo and Simone Rosirota. Why they are not shocked as much as the youngest artisans? Because they are already very old, they already lots of bad stuff in their life, so yes, they are sorry, they are shocked, but not as much as the youngest artists. If you don't mind, I would like to move back with you in the middle part of the room so we can enjoy the whole view, the perfect view of the painting, because the perspective is really great from exactly where we came inside the room. Just to have a look to the crucifix.